Now we are going to start a new chapter of the partnership, that is chapter number 2. The name of the chapter is Reconstitution of Partnership Firm, Change in Profit Sharing Ratio Among the Existing Partners and Goodwill, Nature and Methods of its Valuation. So there are two things in this chapter. One is the change in profit sharing ratio and the other is your goodwill, nature and the method of valuation of goodwill. So reconstitution of partnership. As partnership is a relation between persons who have agreed to share the profits of the business carried on by all or any one of them acting for all, so we find that an essential element of any partnership is agreement among the partners. If there is any change in the partnership agreement, results into the change in the relationship of the partners. So the most essential part of a partnership is the agreement among the partners. And if there is a change in the agreement among the partners, then it is said that there is a change in the relationship of the partners. It is called reconstitution of partnership firm, and this results into a reconstitution of partnership firm. As a result, the existing agreement comes to an end. Whatever agreement was there, that will come to an end, and the firm continues, and the firm will continue, and a new agreement comes into existence. It always leads to the change in profit sharing ratio. The main thing in the reconstitution of the partnership firm is that the profit sharing ratio among the partners will change. The reconstitution of the firm takes place in the following circumstances. The first one we are discussing today, and the others we will discuss tomorrow. Change in the profit sharing ratio among the existing partners. The existing partners may agree to share profits and losses in a ratio different from the earlier agreed profit sharing ratio. Whatever was their profit sharing ratio till the date the change took place will be changed to the new agreed profit sharing ratio. Change in the profit sharing ratio among existing partners results into constitution of partnership firm. And this change in the profit sharing ratio is also a cause of reconstitution of partnership firm. The change in profit sharing ratio leads to dissolution of partnership and not the firm. By the change in profit sharing ratio, the partnership is dissolved, not the partnership firm, because the existing partnership agreement ends and the new agreements come into effect. A change in profit sharing ratio among partners means one or more partners acquire share of profit in the business from another partners. Therefore, the aggregate amount of gain by one or more partner is equal to the aggregate amount of sacrifice by other partners. It means that if one partner is gaining something because of the change in the profit sharing ratio, the other partners are going to sacrifice. In other words, if share of profit of one or more partner increases, then the share of profit of one or more partner decreases. Following issues must be considered carefully due to change in profit sharing ratio. Number one, determination of sacrificing ratio. Number two, determination of gaining ratio. Number three, accounting treatment of goodwill. Number four, accounting treatment of accumulated profits and losses. Number 5, accounting treatment of reserves. Number 6, revaluation of assets and reassessment of liabilities. And number 7, adjustment of capitals of partners. So the first thing is sacrificing ratio. Sacrificing ratio is the ratio in which one partner or more partners of the firm forego, that is sacrifice, their share of profit in favor of one or more partners of the firm. So the ratio in which one or more partners of the firm sacrifices their share for one or more partner of the firm is called sacrificing ratio. Sacrifice share of each partner is calculated as follows. Sacrifice share or sacrificing ratio is equal to old share or ratio minus new share or ratio. The sacrificing ratio is calculated to find out the amount of compensation to be paid by the gaining partner to the sacrificing partner. So sacrificing ratio is calculated to know how much amount is to be paid to the partners who have sacrificed, who have foregone their share by the gaining partners. The compensation is usually paid on the basis of proportionate amount of goodwill, share in accumulated profits and reserves, a profit and loss on revaluation of assets. So the compensation is to be paid on the basis of goodwill, on the basis of profit and loss of the previous years, on the basis of reserves, on the basis of profit and loss on revaluation of assets and liabilities. The partners whose share of profit has reduced due to change in the profit sharing ratio are called sacrificing partners, and the partners whose share reduces are called sacrificing partners, and the partner who gains are called gaining partners. And ratio of reduction in the profit share in favor of other partners is called as sacrificing ratio. Gaining ratio is the ratio in which one or more partners gain share of profits as a result of sacrifice share in profits by one or more partners of the firm. When one or more partner gain the share of profit because of change in profit sharing ratio, then it is called as gaining ratio. Gain share of each partner is calculated as follows. Gain share or ratio is equal to new share or ratio minus old share or ratio. The purpose and importance of calculating gaining ratio is to determine the compensatory amount that the gaining partner shall pay to the sacrificing partner. So here also, the main purpose of calculating this ratio is to know how much the gaining partner is going to pay to the sacrificing partner. Then the third is the new profit sharing ratio, the ratio in which the partners have agreed to share the profits of the firm in future is called as new profit sharing ratio of the firm.